was he?
Just a scumbag. Worked security for the shitheads who ran this place.
Two bullets to the head.
I'd say the shithead got what's come to him.
Hey, can any of you guys see me?
I thought there's supposed to be two bodies here.
I don't know. You know, these people seem pretty drunk around here. Maybe they're seeing double.
Let's check out the rest of this place.
Hey, wait! Can any of you hear me?
Called you guys right away. No one's touched a fucking thing.
Fucking Christ. Who found her?
Found her 15, 20 minutes ago. Got a 911 call from her landlady. Said she hadn't seen her in a couple days, was worried about her. Came down here to investigate.
You a rookie?
Yes, Lieutenant. Graduated from the academy in May.
Welcome aboard.
Garner, look.
What? Who the fuck?
Her heart's been cut out. Her body's been drained of blood.
Christ almighty.
Get forensics down here. I can't take this shit.
Secure this place till forensics gets here.
Yes, sir.
Not even close. Not even close.
Her name is Diane Shaw. She just turned 27. This fiery actress who worked in rock video commercials and shitty movies to pay the rent.
Who found her?
A janitor. I know it doesn't look it, but they actually clean this place sometimes. This way.
Oh, God, it's freezing.
They used to store meat in here. Diana said they still keep it cold. Something about too expensive to change the system.
Shit.
I don't know what to make of this.
It's just like the other one.
Yeah, it is. Same thing you see on the back of a dollar bill.
Maybe this guy's got a beef for the IRS.
Maybe he's just a fucking weirdo.
Professor Shannon?
Yes?
I'm Detective Lutz. And this is Detective Gardner.
Oh, yeah.
Nice to meet you. Thank you for taking the time to see us today.
Great, why don't we talk about this?
Okay.
Now, how is it that you think a little professor of Egyptian paleontology can help you?
We're investigating a series of murders.
I don't know what to make of all this.
These, they're rather graphic.
My God.
I'm sorry.
No, I'm okay.
The first woman was murdered on Monday night, the other one last night.
It may not be anything, but I thought that you might know what these mean.
Yeah, they were on the necks of both victims.
Interesting. May I keep these?
Please. The drawings on the wall, the hearts cut out, the strange markings on the victims' necks. We don't know what we got here, Professor.
It's all very disturbing.
We may be dealing with some psychopath on a loose committing ritualistic murders.
Or maybe the case of a disgruntled medical student, a goddamn butcher, or just some freak who gets his rocks off slicing up women's hearts.
I know it's a long shot, but anything that you could help us with, we'd appreciate.
I'll look these over. Thanks.
You got something for us, Professor?
I discovered the writings on the victim's manual.
What do they say?
I don't know. But what I do know is that it's written in hieroglyphics.
What?
Hieroglyphics. It's the earliest form of writing. The Egyptians used it. You see, they used pictures and symbols to represent words. There were no letters. There was over 50 different forms of hieroglyphics. There's really no way to decipher or translate them. I mean, at best, we can translate maybe 8 or 9 versions. But I don't know if we can translate this one.
Well, what about these women with their hearts cut out? Doesn't that mean anything to you?
You're the experts on that. You tell me.
We've hit a brick wall.
Look, this could be anything. I mean, this could be some sexual perversion. This could be a violent psychopath. I mean, for God's sakes, for all we know, it could be some poor slob who flunked out of medical school. What makes this different is the writings. I mean, Jeffrey Dahmer cut out the heart, but he didn't leave these inscriptions.
What are you driving at?
Go back to 1500 BC. That's the first recorded time in history where the Egyptians started building tombs and burying their kings and pharaohs.
Yeah.
There was an elite class that quickly grew up to service these pharaohs. And they were trained to embalm and bury the kings. And they made a lot of money. And they amassed considerable power in a short amount of time.
You trying to make a connection here?
I don't know, Detective. But something tells me that there might be a connection.
Go on.
So these men would remove all the vital organs from the pharaohs. They believed that this would preserve the bodies longer. 1,000 years later, we realize that this is true.
And you think...
Wait, let me finish. These men would go on with their business, and they taught these skills to their sons. And as Egypt grew in their power and influence, the tombs became larger and larger.
The pyramids.
Right. Mm. And then it happened. There was this terrible massacre outside of the Great Pyramids at Giza. And these embalmers, they went on a rampage, killing and raping and doing all sorts of unspeakable acts.
Why?
No one knows. I mean, some recent historians have said it's because of the carbon dioxide in the pyramids where these men used to work for many hours a day. Others say it's because of the political uprising against the pharaohs because of their corruption and power. But we do know this. Shortly thereafter, the Egyptians stopped making the pyramids and then became their slow, irreversible decline from greatness.
Something tells me that you don't buy that.
Well, around the same time, there was a small religion, a cult really, that grew up outside of Cairo. And it was made up of the same men who used to work in the pyramids. And what they would do is they believed that the Egyptians had angered the gods. And in the pyramids, instead of showing man's superior knowledge, they represented man's ego and vanity and pride. So they used their skills to kill and disembowel many of the members of the upper strata of society. They believed that they were appeasing the gods. So needless to say, the authorities quickly gathered them up and executed them. But it's believed that many of them escaped and went to Rome and to Spain, and that this cult grew for another 200 years and didn't die out until around the time of Christ's birth.
So if it died out, then what's the problem?
That's the problem. Many scholars believe that it never died out.
What are you saying?
I have a friend who works at Yale, and he believes that there's members of this cult that are still around today.
In Los Angeles, in 1996? I mean, we'd have some weird stuff going down here, but a religious cult that rips out women's hearts?
I don't know, Detective. But your killer is obviously very sick. And unlike most killers, he has specialized skills and knowledge. He can cut with the precision of a surgeon, and he can write hieroglyphics with the knowledge of a scholar.
So we canvass the medical schools and colleges looking for this freak.
I can give you the names of the people who know this language. I mean, there can't be more than 50 or 60 of them in the whole world. Thanks. You're welcome. Thanks, everybody. Glad I could be here.
Thank you.
So you don't buy it?
Not a word. She seems like a bright woman, but I think she's got a couple of screws loose.
Oh, and you got a better theory? Last week, two women killed, both with their hearts cut out.
Yeah, I think the killer's some scrawny little white guy who lives with his mother, probably out in the valley. His mother thinks he's a good little boy, but in the basement, he's got a room full of guns and a big stack of porno magazines. Just some sick fuck with a really bad sex life and a shitty attitude.
You're wrong.
I don't think so. You know how we solved this case?
How's that?
A year from now, a cop pulls over a crappy van for running through a red light. The guy in the van panics and says how he likes to cut up women's hearts. Cop says, why do you do that? And the guy says, because when he was 3 years old, he saw his dad naked or something.
You never cease to amaze me.
What do you got for me in the big case?
We got two dead girls. One found in Westwood, one found in Hollywood. Both in the 20s, aspiring actresses, and both with their hearts cut out.
You're yanking my chain.
No, we're not.
Unbelievable. Any leads?
We're working on the case right now for you, Captain.
Yeah, we've been working with what is her name?
Shannon. Professor Shannon at SC. She thinks that the killer might be a medical student or a doctor or someone in the medical profession.
Why is that?
He cuts like a pro, sir.
Detective Garner?
Yeah, that's me.
I have some information I think you might find useful.
Sweetheart, everybody's got some information they think I might need. I'm a busy man, you know what? I cannot get your pimp out of jail.
Look, I'm not a hooker, detective.
Ah, congratulations. I gotta go, though.
Look, I need your help.
I don't have time.
Will Spanner said to contact you.
I do not have time for Will Spanner right now.
No. Let her talk.
Look, Will said to talk to you that his girlfriend Kelly was in trouble.
I'm not a bodyguard. And you tell Will Spanner, last time he helped us out on a case, it did not turn out so hot.
What kind of trouble?
Look, it's kind of hard to explain, really.
Let's blow this chick up. She's wasting our time.
No, I want to hear what she has to say.
She's a flake. You've been busted before. Didn't I bust you a couple of years ago down on Sunset Boulevard?
What did Will tell you?
Look, it's really weird shit.
Goodbye.
Look, he told me to talk to you, but that you'd understand. He said that the curse had been broken and that it was more powerful and stronger than ever.
What else? What else did he tell you?
He told me to tell you what I saw.
And what did you see?
At Kelly's house. I saw a man in the basement.
What did he look like?
I couldn't tell. He was wearing a hood.
Well, do you have a name?
I didn't actually meet him. Like, I think maybe his name was Kiefer, Kofer, Kofu, maybe?
Kofu.
Yeah, I think that was his name.
Well, where's Will now?
Well, he's in hiding, sort of. That's why he asked me to contact you.
So this guy, Kofu, he's the one that's been threatening Will and Kelly?
Yes, I think so.
You think so? What the hell are you saying? You want us to arrest some fat guy named Kofu because Will Spanner doesn't like him?
Look, he scares me.
Has he been threatening you?
No, it's just, look, I'm really scared. Look, I know you think I'm crazy or I'm full of shit, but look, you gotta believe me. I saw this guy with
what?
Look, he was in the basement and in Kelly's house in front of this altar in the middle of the room with
what? You have to tell me what he had. Please, you have to tell me.
With a goddamn human heart. He was holding it in his hand. Like it was a piece of candy. I gotta go.
Jesus, I gotta
rest. Have you notified the newspapers, radio, TV about these murders?
No, nothing. Why?
So we got a witness.
The hooker?
She saw this guy, Kofu, holding a heart in his hand.
In Will Spanner's basement?
If this hasn't been in the papers or anything yet, she's telling the truth.
We gotta keep her under wraps.
Get her down to the print artist. We need to make a sketch on this guy, and then we'll let her go.
Let her go?
Yeah, we'll get an ID on the freak, and then we'll try to match fingerprints, DNA, hair fibers, anything that puts him at the crime scene. I don't want to let this son of a bitch walk.
Spanners? 202.
Right, 202.
Look at this place. Didn't Spanner used to live in a big house over on Harvard?
Yeah. And when was the last time you ever saw him win a case?
Yeah, maybe we can stop chasing monsters. Van Gogh suite?
Maybe Spanner's on acid.
Maybe that's why he's so fucking weird.
Come on, let's go check out the basement.
LAPD, put your fucking hands up! Stop, asshole!
Drop the sickle now!
Stay there, copper. I'm gonna cut her. I'll cut her good. Immediate, copper. Jackie's gonna slice her.
Drop her!
Yeah, and I don't wanna like it too, and I'm gonna enjoy it, baby. Stay away, copper, I'm telling you. Stay back.
I'm not moving. Am I, baby? Am I, baby? Oh, Jackie likes it.
Freeze, asshole!
I wish we could get rid of all scum this easily.
It isn't as easy as skimming petri dishes in high school, Gardner. If it was, we'd have a scum of society.
Hey, wouldn't that be something?
Yeah, but you and me, we'd be out of a job.
Yeah. Look.